people will not listen to false prophecies, prophecies of fear or prophecies of confidence. There's a part in the Bible where when the Lord said something to one of those prophets, and some other prophets got up and said the opposite, saying, "Don't mind him, don't mind him. The Lord did not say so. Don't fear the Lord. You shall eat in fat and plenty. Your land shall be filled." They prophesied opposite. And people began to relax. If one person should prophesy good, and the other person, and ten other ministers are prophesying, trusted prophets are prophesying opposite. You know, it's just normal for human beings to go for the same. But you know, most of the time, it is not the majority that carries the vote. And also at this point in time, there's a spirit of deception. So we're going to pray. Maybe it's that little child that is saying to what I saw. Or that little, that prophet or that pastor with only 5 or 10 members in his church. Whoever that, the report that we are supposed to believe and ask from, the Lord will cancel off false prophets. Then just like that. Any false prophet that wants to get up and confess, make a lie to us, to confuse us, either to the positive or to the negative. The Lord is still there now.
We refuse to hear any false prophecy in Nigeria, in the mighty name of Jesus. There shall be no any evil prophecy from all the prophets in Nigeria, finally, in the mighty name of Jesus.
This thing I'm talking about, to happen quickly. Yes, we are saying let it happen on time.
My Father, my God.
I read something in the paper.
Yes.
Which I may not want to say in the air.
Okay.
But I know that He has brought help and He should bring you more help. So let us begin to pray.
Okay.
Let us pray. When we cannot pray at times, we just need to pray in the spirit.
Okay.
So Father, we just have to lift up this matter to your
This matter. This matter matters to us, Almighty God.
Therefore,
in the mighty name of Jesus,
of the evil one,
your prophecy shall not go in the way of the evil ones in the name of Jesus. My Father, my God, every word of prophecy, no matter how small it is, in the mighty name of Jesus, we will not go into the hands of the headsmen. In the mighty name of Jesus, nothing shall be broken. Nothing that shall be broken. Nothing shall be missing in our nation. In the mighty name of Jesus, my Father, my God, the hands of the enemies will not prevail. The hands of the enemy shall not prevail over Nigeria, over our people. In the mighty name of Jesus, the gate of hell, you shall not prevail. In the mighty name of Jesus, in the name that is above all other names, in the mighty name of Jesus, my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord God Almighty, the hand of the evils shall not prevail over us, over Christianity, over your children, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Lord God Almighty, because begin to bring all sorts of rules. Father, we come to by the blood of Jesus. We are not going to wait until such legislators stand before the state. We come to it. They will never be able to gather the state.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Heavenly Father, we say no. We say no. We say no. We say no.
We say capital. We say no. We say capital no. In Nigeria. In the mighty name of Jesus, our eyes are open. Our children's eyes are open. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. My Father, my God. Father, we ask of you. In the name of Jesus. Every power that wants to oppress, every spirit of oppression, we take it out. We take it out. No more killing. No more killing of your children. In the mighty name of Jesus. It shall not stand. Evil plans of the enemies shall not stand. Shall not come to pass. In the mighty name of Jesus. My Father, my God, there shall be no more killing. There shall be no more killing the innocent people. In the mighty name of Jesus. There shall be no more killing. There shall be no no more killing of the innocent. Every evil plan of the enemies shall not come to pass. In the mighty name of Jesus, your name shall not be dragged into the mud. In the name of Jesus, our Father and our God, Lord God Almighty. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Our Father, let your fire, let the fire of the Holy Spirit fight for us. Fire of the Holy Spirit. Prevail over Nigeria. Prevail, Almighty God. In the name of Jesus, let the power, let the fire, fire of the Holy Spirit, fire of the Holy Ghost, destroy every evil plan of the enemy concerning Nigeria, concerning the agitators, in the mighty name of Jesus. It shall not stand. It shall not stand. It shall not come to pass. In the mighty name of Jesus. It shall not stand. It shall not come to pass. In the mighty name of Jesus. Our Father and our God. Father, we thank you. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Mashakati libo shekete tatata ya. Mami bo shinde libo. Evil plant of the enemy. We cancel you. We destroy you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Every form of oppression. Every oppression of the citizens. Our Father and our God, we cancel it. We cancel it in the name of Jesus. Yes, we cancel it. We cancel it. Every incessant killings of the innocent, or every shedding of the blood is cancelled. In the mighty name of Jesus, we cancel the shedding of the blood of the innocent. In the mighty name of Jesus, we cancel it. We cancel it. In the mighty name of Jesus, Isaiah 7:7 says, "It shall not stand. It shall not come to pass. The plans of the enemies shall not come to pass in the lives of our people." In Nigeria, in the mighty name of Jesus, Oluwa edide togun togun, edide tija tija, edide kewa gbeja awon omo yin, edide toju togun, edide tija tija, ewa gbeja awon omo yin ni oruko Jesu, Oluwa, edide togun togun, edide tija tija, ewa gbeja awon omo yin ni oruko Jesu, edide togun togun, edide tija tija, edide Olorun wa ko wa gbeja awon omo re. Oluwa mi edide togun togun, edide tija tija, ewa gba wa ja, ewa wa ja, a le daja, a le daja, emi ro wa lowo Jesu, a o le dase, a o le dase, ayeraye o le dase, a o le dase, Olorun anu, Olorun ijile fe, a o le dase, eran wa lowo Oluwa. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Oluwa eran wa lowo. You are the lion of the tribe of Judah. Father, we thank you. We give you all the glory. We honor you. We adore you. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Daddy, are you here? Let us continue to let us Daddy, okay, you are here, sir. God bless you, sir. Yes, sir, we can hear your voice. So boy, on mute. On mute, Daddy. You are still muted. Agbon you. We can't hear you, sir. Le mo daju pe Jesu ni kon loba. Daddy, devices meji len lo. So, one is muted, one is unmuted. So, we can't hear you. Agbon you rara. Ki gbogbo araye le mo daju wipe Jesu ni kan loba lori aye gbogbo baba fagbara re hun Daddy agbo daju wipe Jesu ni kan loba lori aye gbogbo baba fagbara re hun Olúwa ẹ fagbára yín hàn ní orúkọ Jésù. Ẹ̀mí mímọ́ ẹ fagbára hàn, ẹ fagbára yín hàn lórí ayé wa, lórí gbogbo àgbáyé. Ẹ fagbára yín hàn ní orúkọ Jésù, ní orúkọ Jésù. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let us pray for the youth, for the teenagers and the youth in Nigeria, because they said they have been disoriented. They have been disoriented, and the youth, the teenagers, they are the future of Nigeria. We want to pray for them. We want to pray for them that the hands of the Lord will be upon them, that they will not be disoriented, that they will be discouraged, and they will fight for their future. So let us pray. Our Father and our God, we thank you. Thank you for the opportunity to pray with you. Thank you for the opportunity that you have given to us to pray for our youth, for our teenagers, for Nigerians, for the agitators. Father, we pray, Almighty God, that your children will not be disoriented, that they will know you, they will know that everything, every good and great gift cometh from you, Almighty God, that your children will not be disoriented, that they will be able to fight their battle in the mighty name of Jesus. And the Bible says, God, you will fight our battle, and we will never have to lift a finger. Therefore, our Father and our God, we pray for all your children. We pray from the teenagers to the youth and younger daughter. Father, the grace to know their right, the grace to fight their battle, the grace to make you number one, the grace to call on you. Father, give to them in the name of Jesus. With the grace to call on you before they take any decision. Somebody was telling me that after answers, not all the youth. And if you look at it, ma, even for this agitation, you will see that apart from those following Chief Sunday Igbo, you don't see any other youth out there, you know, fighting or agitating again because of what they did to them in October 2020. We want to say, Father, let the wickedness of the wicked, let it perish. Let the wickedness of the wicked perish with the wicked. Adra, my Father, my God, in the name of Jesus, as an individual and as a family, we pray in Almighty God, let the wickedness of the wicked perish, perish, perish in the name of Jesus. Wickedness of the wicked, we ask that you perish and you shall rise no more in the name of Jesus. Wickedness of the wicked, we ask that you perish forever, that you will not rise again in the mighty name of Jesus. In Nigeria, people are so wicked. You see people killing people for ritual. We want to say, Father, no more ritualistic activities. Father, I want us to pray that God, the Holy Spirit, will go into the nooks and crannies of their life, so they will know that there's nothing on this earth that they brought and they will take with them. When we all came, when we were born, we came naked. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I don't know why they don't sit back and think, my Lord, my God, my Lord, my God. Oh yeah, Holy Spirit. Oh, one way you want to go back for one more. Let them know you. Let them know you in the mighty name of Jesus. Let them know you in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Daddy is back.
Amen.
Amen. Daddy, over to you, sir. Over to you, sir.
Before I say anything, may God bless us. What Pastor Abimbola just said,
okay,
we had it, was it last year? Yeah, concerning the Canaan land and other big churches in Nigeria.
Yes, yes.
That the only solution is to pray.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe the Lord is saying, the Lord from all revelation, the Lord is saying, it's the prayer of the saints that have sustained that place.
Yes.
It could have been worse than that.
I remember, sir. Remember, they caught somebody with arms and ammunition, I think about
yes,
about 4 or 5 months ago. And it was it couldn't detonate or something. Something like that.
Work here, So that is to let us know that God is talking to us, and it's a good thing that you are listening.
Yes.
You know, prayer is the answer. The Lord, told us, he said, 5 of us will take 100.
Yes.
And 100 of us will put 10,000 to flight.
Yes.
So it's the prayer of the saint that is still working this miracle.
Yes.
Recently, you know, I like prophets, especially when they are coming from people of God. Okay. Mm-hmm. For example, the man of God, Segun Adebayo, the one I worked overnight. He was saying that the Lord said, don't even talk about that place anymore because it does not exist in the calendar. You know? So he said, because of the wickedness of the egg, of the people in authority, he thinks. So, and that he has decided to pass judgment upon them. Mm. That place does not exist anymore. You know? So I believe that. You know? Yeah, and if it is true that somebody went to the Republic of Benin to solicit. I don't know whether it is true because it's very difficult nowadays to know which one is true and which one is not. You know. So they have been going with us. So
amen.
The consolation I get today is that it's from the book of Isaiah 35, telling us that the lost people will have joy, you know, and believe. But one is telling us that peace and joy will come back to our forest. I believe that. The wilderness and the solitary place shall be glad for you.
Yes.
And the desert shall rejoice and blossom as the rose. So we believe God is able. There's nothing the Lord cannot do.
Yes.
I pray in the name of Jesus Christ, God will rectify all the anomalies. The second one, he says he shall blossom abundantly and rejoice, even with joy and singing. The glory of Lebanon shall be given unto it. The excellency of Carmel and Sharon they shall see the glory of the Lord and excellency of our Lord God. We believe God is able to restore all the Lord's glory, all the Lord's glory, all the years the locals are facing. I believe the Lord God will do it. It's a God that is able.
Yes.
Verse 3 says, he will send the weak hand and confirm the feeble knees. God is the one that is able. All those who have lost hope, Jehovah God, will come to their rescue. Because compliment of the prayer ministration of those who are diligently seeking the Lord on daily basis across the globe.
Yes.
The body of Christ is praying around the clock, whenever we like it. And God will listen. He always listens to the prayer of his beloved.
Yes.
The verse 4 says, say to them that are of his careful heart, be strong. Fear not, behold, your God will come with vengeance, even God with recompense.
Yes.
He will come and save you. The Lord God, all the prophecies are saying that God is the one, he's saying, the fury is going to.